Welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be talking about very exciting topic, various ways to communicate. You know, the last time we talked about communication, I told you that communication is essential. It's very important. It makes the bond to be stronger. But today, just stay with me. Let me tell you about the various ways we can communicate, not just the verbal way we know, the other ways we can communicate. Stay with me as we go right now. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. How are you doing? This is Counseling with Juliet. Like I said before, there are various ways we can communicate. We all know the verbal way we communicate. We communicate by talking to each other. That's the verbal way we know. But we have other ways that we can communicate that I will be talking about today. Just watch this video to the end and you're going to learn something from me. And not just watching alone, please share to people. That it will be of a benefit to a lot of people also when they watch it. And also, if you have not subscribed, please hit the subscribe button right now and the notification bell so that it will notify you whenever I upload new videos. How are you doing today? I can see everything is coming back now. Yeah, we thank God. We know that the Lord has done it and it is permanent. So today I will be talking about various ways we can communicate. Apart from the normal verbal way we all know that we communicate, talking to each other, there are other ways that you can communicate. There are other ways you can communicate with your spouse, not just only talking. When last did you write your spouse a love letter? If our social media even help it more, not like the time we started, that we have to write letter and carve the letter and give it to our brother. Don't let daddy see that letter. Just take it down to him. Do you understand? But now, at least there are other ways we can communicate. That is number one, the writing communication. You communicate by writing. You write your spouse. You write, I love you. You are the best thing that happened to me. Put it under the pillow. Oh, let me tell you, it will spark up the marriage again, you know, like never before. And even text a message. You can text a message through your phone. Just write a love letter. If it has not been you, I don't know where I would have been. God brought you into my life for a purpose. God has made you to be my king. God has made you to be my queen. Please communicate by writing. There are some of us, we just say that maybe we want to, like, a busy state where we are going to job and we want our spouse to help us get something. We just put it in writing. Please, darling, when you come back from work, please buy me a bottle of Coke. And at the end, you forget to even put something to acknowledge he or she. It's bad. You are supposed to, after writing that, honey, get me a bottle of Coke when you come back from work. Honey, I love you. You are the best thing that happens to me. Put it there. When he sees it, let me tell you, me, I love communication this way, communication by writing. I like it so much because when I see it, I'm not even moved with the other things you wrote there. I'm just concerned about, I'm the best thing that happened to him. Oh God, this is wonderful. It has a way of putting more spices to your marriage. That is another way. Communicate by writing. Write it, even at home. At times you see your spouse is not in a happy mood. You can communicate, just put it there, honey. I like it when you smile. Put it under the pillow. At times, put it inside his shoe. The shoe that you know that he's going to wear out. He will hug you and he will feel so, you know, acknowledged. Please do that if you have not been doing it. The second way that you can communicate, that is the eye communication. I call it communication by eyes. Do you know that these eyes talk? A lot of us don't know. It's only when we are angry we can excuse it so that the world will see. Let me see, tell you, that one doesn't help. Your eyes can talk. It can pass message. A lot of various messages that your eyes will pass. You can't do it. Communicate by your eyes. Look at your spouse. Wink your eyes around him or her. Make her feel loved. Make her feel pleasant. You know, communication through eyes not only help at home, you help outside also. When you go out, you are out there with your spouse. You don't want people to understand what you are saying. You can communicate with your eyes. Two of you understand each other because it is something that you are doing always. Somebody once told me, my husband is outside, he wants to say something. I try to, you know, use my eyes to communicate. The next thing, we say, why are you looking at me like that? Or even use your leg to touch. Why are you touching me with your legs? Because why? They have not been practicing it. They are not used to it. But no, trust me, I love it. I can communicate with my eyes. I can tell my husband, it's okay. I can tell him, okay, let's move. With my eyes, we communicate and we understand each other. It's another best way you can communicate. you communicate with your eyes, you look around your spouse, you admire what you see, you admire the goodness of God, you admire what God has created. And you can use your eyes to talk in many ways and we understand. That is why I tell you, some people, they are angry, their spouse will not even know. They don't understand the communication of eyes. When the person is not in the right mood, is angry, he or she will not understand until we not tell her, don't you know that I was angry? And you say, really? I didn't know you were angry. Ah, because why? You lack the eyes communication. Please, today I want you to try these things. I'm telling you, it really works. It really helps. It strengthens the marriage. It puts more spices on it. You know, you cannot just be doing it the same way. I believe somebody out there is blessed. And also another communication before I will go, I'm just going to take a chapter. The other one that I will talk about is the body language communication. You communicate with your body. Ah, communicate with your body. Body language. Touch yourselves. You are at home, touch your spouse. There are some people, it is only when they want to make love or have sex with their spouse that they touch them. It's not good. It kills the love. It makes it like one way thing. When you touch, even when you're in the kitchen, there are times your spouse might just be carried away with something that you don't even understand. But when you just pass through her back and touch her, she will just be relieved. That touch, you touch her in the sensitive part, you will find out that she will be relieved. She will just relax, because when you touch her, she now know that yes, there's somebody living with her at home. A lot of men in this aspect, they are very rigid. Sorry to say, they don't touch their wives. Touch her. When you are going on the street, hold her hands. Let your hands be communicated. You can touch your spouse's hand and you are communicating with your hand, with your touch. Touch her in the kitchen, touch her in the car when you are driving with her. But be careful not to get accidents. So communicate, body communication. It is very powerful. Try it. Not just by talking and talking and talking. At times you get tired of that. You communicate various ways. There are much more various ways that you can communicate. But you can only achieve this is when you are friendly. When you are not friendly, you are doing it, you look as if you are just playing. Or you are not serious about what you are doing. When you are friendly, that is why we always advise you marry your friend. Because when you are friendly, you can communicate in any way. And you will find out that it will just change the atmosphere of everything. And please, one thing I will beg you, don't mock your spouse. There are a lot of us, we mock our spouse, we bring them down by the words we tell them. You make her or he to feel that he is so weak. Don't use their weaknesses to mock them. Nobody is perfect. Don't use their weaknesses to mock them. Let them, even when in that place where they are weak, that's where God brought you into their lives. Because God wants you to come and help him or she build her up, build her self-esteem. Don't bring her down. Whereby you will see some men will tell you, your mates are doing this, you also want to do it. Please get into the house. You are not caught there. Why? Also, women will tell the husband, don't you see that your mate, you can't do this? Don't bring them down. In their weaknesses, that is why you are there for them. The Bible says two is better than one. You are there to strengthen her, to strengthen him. So whenever you see that weakness is coming up, call them. Talk to each other. Communicate. Various ways you can communicate. A lot of ways that you can communicate and you will enjoy it. Not just because you want to have sex. That's when you now know that you can say, honey, you look so beautiful. Honey, I love you. It shouldn't be like that. It should be everyday thing. When last did you write a love letter? Write love letter. The way we did it those days, when social media was not even available. I wrote a lot of love letters. I bought a lot of cards. When last, let us bring it back to our marriages. Let us bring it back to our home. And you see that the whole thing will spice it up. It will give it another brighter color. I promise you, if you do this, you will see changes in your home. In case you have not subscribed, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And please share. And at least, I want to see your comments. Your comments will help us a lot. Comment, talk to us. Don't be afraid. Your identity, it can never be disclosed. Don't be afraid. Just talk to us, whatever you want us to talk about. By the help of God, it will be done. Until I come your way next time, have a nice day and bye.